BBC Radio 1.
An aesthetic history of the 1975 with Matty from the 1975. And then we kind of went into this baroque kind of... I'm actually in that photo, you can't really see, but I'm on the right-hand side texting as a little homage to A Brief Inquiry. Oh, they're coming, the phones are coming. Little Easter eggs. But it's because when I was a kid and I was playing video games, I'd be playing like Echo the Dolphin, and then the thousandth time I'd play it, I'd jump at a particular time and press the button, and I'd go into a different world where programmers would do that. They would put little Easter eggs, and I felt like it was talking to me. It's more like a natural conclusion that in the way that our records sound mental or whatever, it's only because we don't want to be bored, and we make music all the time, so they have to sound mental to not be bored. I make artwork all the time, like I don't want to be bored, so I make it fun. And then we go into Music for Cars / A Brief Inquiry. You know, I'd been to like rehab and stuff. Give Yourself a Try video was the first time I'd like performed in like 18 months. There's this whole kind of like performance of reinvention that felt really weird. I didn't really know where I was at. I didn't really know. I just knew that I'd made my best record. So I didn't want to worry about how to present it too much. I wanted it to be clinical. So it was very raw. I think that, you know, I love like art and typography. So the Swiss Masters is what that kind of looks like. It wasn't really referencing anything more. It was a kind of like a clean, modern deconstruction of what was happening. Yeah, Fripp and Eno. Was it Pussyfooting? No Pussyfooting or whatever? Yeah. It's, I mean, Brian Eno's kind of in all popular music, but he's very much in our kind of DNA. And I think that it was a reference to that performance scene is a direct reference to that. But I'm very lucky as well because I'm so self-referential and I'm so obsessed with references. And when I do an interview, I'll reference a million things a minute. I kind of get away with referencing other people's art because people kind of know what I'm doing. They don't think I'm just copying because why would I copy? I'm so obsessed with going, look at, do you know how, look, this guy, you know.
Irony's a case pose, culture is to blame.
Listen, Sam is a monster now, you know, like we've gotten so much better at what we do and we really share a language. So very seldom will Sam send me something and I'm like, no, you know, me and Sam, like we do very, and Jamie and Ed, we do very little. Most things are first, second drafts, not because we're genius, but because like this is what we've been doing for a long time. And like, I really trust Sam's eye because he knows exactly who I am. We lived with each other for like 3 years. We share a dog, you know, so we share an aesthetic as well. Yeah, so Notes on a Conditional Form is now, I think, a deconstruction of the already deconstructed. So we're getting into like fabric and material and texture. The 1975 is me channeling what I'm into, interpreting what I'm into, songs that I'm into most of the time. But like, if you saw my house, you'd really understand Notes on a Conditional Form, do you know what I mean? Because it's all very raw, very kind of like wabby savvy. I've got that tattooed in my mouth, but it's gone because it fades, which is the idea of wabby savvy. You know why I did that? Because I'm a you're gonna have to bleep that out.